play for you the first song I ever learned to play on a guitar. This is the song. I heard this song. I didn't realize when I heard it, it was gonna ruin my life. I was just out of the Navy, and I was going to college in New York City in 1966. And I heard a fella at the Folklore Center in New York picking this Candyman blues. And it tickled my ear. I just knew I had to do it. And after a while, I asked this fella if he could teach me how to do such an incredible thing, and he said no. But I kept listening anyway. When he was finished, he handed me a matchbook with a phone number on it. The number was AX17609. I said, "What's that phone number?" He said, "That's the number to call if you want to play the guitar like that." He said, "That's Reverend Gary Davis's phone number." Mercy. I knew about Reverend Gary Davis, the legendary blind preacher, came to New York in 1935 to make blues records with Blind Boy Full and Sonny Terry. He recorded two beautiful blues numbers. Then he got religion. 2 hours in the big city and he got religion. The big city will do that to some. He recorded 10 beautiful Christian songs, and then the man wanted more blues. And Reverend Davis said he wasn't going to mess with the blues anymore, and he was pushed out of the studio where he stayed. Sang on the streets of New York for 25 years or so. About 1960, folk music started to happen. Peter, Paul, and Mary recorded a song they heard old blind Gary singing on 135th Street and Lenox Avenue on the streets. Reverend Davis hit pay dirt. The publishers asked him if he wrote the song If I Had My Way. Reverend Davis tilted his head back in the chair and said he never wrote any songs. That song was revealed to him in the spring of 21. Make a short story longer than it could be. Reverend Davis put his mark down and they counted out $500 for Reverend Davis in 1960. That was a lot of money. It's more money than I'm making a night 40 years later. Reverend Davis built him a house in Long Island. We still lovingly refer to as the house that Peter, Paul, and Mary built. I had the phone number. I was shy about calling up the blind Reverend. Finally, I got up my courage and I dialed it up. AX17609. Old man answered the phone. I said, "Reverend Davis." He said, "That's my name." He said, "My name's Roy and I sure like the way you play a guitar. Could you show me how to do it?" He said, "Do you have any money?" I said, "How much does it cost?" He said, "$5 to get you a guitar lesson." When are you coming over? I was still shy about it. I said, "How about a week from Thursday?" He said, "Reverend Davis is an old man, you know. So you better come and get it while it's still here." I said, "When?" He said, "Now." Man, I was shaking in my boots. I said, "How am I gonna get over there? I live in Manhattan." He said, "You get on the subway train." I got my guitar packed up and went down on the subway train. I had a choice. I could take the E train, the F train, or the A train. I took the A train, but I ended up in Brooklyn. I was supposed to go to Queens on the E train or the F train. Got me a transfer, you know, and I finally did get over there. I knew it would sound so cool in 25 years to say I took the A train. That's why I did it. I got to Reverend Davis's house and we picked guitars from 1 o'clock in the afternoon till 8 o'clock at night. He said, "What can you play?" I played him the Candyman blues. He said, "Good God Almighty, it's gonna take years to straighten you out." I said, "I got lots of time." He said, "You might. I'm an old man." Man, we picked and picked, and then Mrs. Davis called us up for supper. We had boiled turkey wings with tomato paste on them and collard greens with a big nasty ham hock floating in there. 1966, I was a vegetarian. Long hair, mustache. I had seconds, realizing that one must suffer to sing the blues. After supper, we went back down in the basement, Reverend Davis's finished playroom, and the motion picture version of my life, we're gonna be on the streets of Harlem, you watch. We picked guitars till 2 o'clock in the morning. I says, Reverend Davis, he said, Roy, that's what he called me by then. I said, I gotta get out of here. I got an 8 o'clock class tomorrow. I'm a schoolboy. He said, don't forget. I said, I'll never forget as long as I live, Reverend Davis. He said, what are you talking about? Don't forget you owe me $5, your guitar lesson. So I gave him five. That's where that expression started, Reverend Davis's house. Next day I was back at Reverend Davis's house at 10:30 in the morning, took the right train and everything. By the third day I sublet my apartment, dropped out of college, and me and Reverend Davis were on the road. I've been on the road ever since. We were in Chicago one time and I says, Reverend Davis, and he said, Roy, that's what he called me, like I said. I said, when did you write the Candyman Blues song? He said, I never wrote that Candyman Blues song. I said, everybody in New York City says you did. He said, that goes to show you something. I said, well, if you didn't write that song, when did that song come out? He said, that's an old song, come out for. I said, for what? He said, what are you talking about? I said, when that song came out. He said, for, 1904. I said, mercy, that's an old song. He said, that's what I've been trying to teach you this morning. I said, well, what was going on in Greenville, South Carolina back in for, Reverend Davis? He said, I don't know, I haven't been to town yet. So I said, you must have still been in Great Court, South Carolina, is that right? He said, that's right. I said, what was going on there, Reverend Davis? He said, nothing ever went on there, that's why I moved to Greenville. Wasn't easy learning about this, but I think it was easy. I said, Reverend Davis, back in four, what were you doing in Great Court, South Carolina, the first time you heard somebody pick the Candyman Blues? He said, I was a little blind baby boy playing in the mud in front of my mama's house, and I heard it coming up the street. Sounded like a brass band in a parade, tickled my ear. I said, Mama, she said, little Reverend Davis, anything in this God Almighty world to keep the Candyman home. He said, what's that coming up the street sound like a parade? She said, nothing but a nasty old guitar picker playing a Candyman Blues. He said, you better get me one of them things. She did, he did, and here we are. I'd do anything in this God Almighty world to keep the Candyman home. Big Leg Ida, ooh, Big Leg Ida, Big Leg Ida, Candyman, Big Leg Ida. Sure do love that big leg gal, God knows I do. Spartanburg, South Carolina. I was hanging out with an old guitar picker named Pink Anderson. He had arthritis. Didn't play guitar much, but one day he picked up my guitar. Started picking like that. I said, that's the old Candyman Blues song. He said, yeah, and that's an old song come out before your time. I said, four. He said, how'd you know that? I said, I've been around, Pink. I've been around. Run and get the bucket, get the baby some beer. Run and get the bucket, get the baby Candyman. Run and get the bucket, get the baby some beer. Ooh, I'd do anything in this God Almighty world to keep the Candyman home. Asked Pink what he was doing back and forth when he heard that song. He said, I was a little baby boy playing in the mud in front of my mama's house. Guitar picker was coming up the road. He said, it was a crazy thing. Back and forth, before automobiles and radios and television, before noise had come south. You could hear them guitar strings singing across the hills. He said, people were going crazy. Men were throwing money at that guitar picker, and women were flat out tearing clothes off. I said, Mama, you better get me one of them guitars. She didn't, he didn't. Here we are. Candyman, Dave Van Ronk. Candyman, Salty Dog. Candyman. Ooh, I wish I was down in New Orleans just sitting on a Candyman stand.